name is Emma Brown. I'm the horn player for the Red Cedar Brass, whose recital you're about to watch. We're based on the campus of Michigan State University. So what happens is every year they put together a brass quintet out of that freshman class, and you go through the 4 years of school together, and you play, and you have to give recitals every semester. So we're the freshman honors quintet this year. This is our first recital ever. We had been together for 11 weeks at this point, so be nice to us, please. We know that there are issues, we're fixing them. I think it went pretty well, except for a few things. The way that we had to record it, it sounds better with like headphones or earphones, so if you're not using them, I would recommend that. And also, my laptop and I are both idiots, and so that combination caused us to run out of storage space, and our last song gets cut off. And you'll know when that happens because I'm going to come back on, and you're going to be in my dorm room again, and it'll be great, and it'll be fun, and we can hang here for as long as you want. We really hope that you enjoy what you're about to hear. We hope that it inspires you and it brightens your day and all those great things. So without further ado, here's the Red Cedar Brass coming at you from Michigan State University. Enjoy.
Tonight is the first concert by our freshman brass quintet, and it's been a privilege for me to work with this group over the last 11 weeks, and I think you'll really enjoy their performance. Like most of our quintets, they've grown not just in their playing ability, but as a family, as all of our quintets do, and they've learned how to work together and to sort out musical problems and to present challenges as a group, as well as to show their individual strengths. So it's been a thrill to work with them. I think you'll enjoy the basis they have for a great 4 years together here at MSU. The other reason for making an announcement is that this is, believe it or not, the very first concert in our renovated room 120, now known as Hollander Hall, even though it's been in this state pretty much since September 1, it's been used mostly as a classroom and a rehearsal site for choral ensembles and for the opera. And now we're getting to use it as they do various touches bit by bit for recitals. And so tonight's program is actually the first concert in this renovated room, a room that's been our primary large ensemble rehearsal space for 79 years. And starting in a few months, we'll have a couple more large rehearsal rooms across the way in the Billman Pavilion. But this is a room where our students have trained in orchestras and bands for many years. For many years, room 120 was known as the band room. And so this is a room that all of our ensemble conductors, including Leonard Falcone, did their teaching for many, many decades. It's also a room where we've been able to feature many incredible artists who've been here on campus to present classes for our students. I remember 25 or 30 years ago, we had a fantastic group, the Empire Brass, in this room, standing right about here. And we were doing a concert at Wharton and gave a nice session for us. This room is full of those memories and will continue along that track in a format that's almost finished. I think as you come back over the next few months, you'll see there'll be more curtains, acoustical banners, some other treatment to the wood and the floor, and it will just continue to be a better and better space for us. So I'll turn it over to the freshman quintet, and they know how to work the lights, evidently, as well as present a great concert for you. So thank you for being here.
We're the Red Cedar Brass Quintet. We're the freshman honors group here. And we really are glad that you made it out tonight. The piece that we just played for you is called Processional. It's by a man named Paul Basler. And it was written for a wedding. I wish that I could tell you about the people that it was written for. But when I Googled their names, the only thing that came up were lists of obituaries. And none of the obituaries were theirs. So I'm not sure why that happened. Maybe they're both undertakers. I don't know. So yeah, can't really tell you if they're still together or not. But that's what that piece was written for. So I guess I can tell you about the composer. His name's Paul Basler. He's a horn player, so very near and dear to my heart. He is a professor of horn and composition at the University of Florida. And he has toured all around the world, and he composes a lot for brass ensembles, and also in recent years he's done a lot of horn solos. So yeah, he's a big brass guy. So we're glad that we could play that for you. And now I'd like to invite up Brian. He's going to tell you about our next piece.
All right, hello everyone. Thanks for coming out. So for our next piece, the Quintet Number 2 by Victor Ewald. Just a little bit about Victor Ewald. He was a composer from Russia. He was born and raised in St. Petersburg. And this piece we're playing, the first movement of his Quintet Number 2, was composed in 1894. So please enjoy our next piece, Victor Ewald Quintet Number 2. Thank you.
Thank you.
or not this piece, this song. This song came out in 1977. It instantly hit number one on the 100 Billboard chart, and it's been famous ever since. Sing along. Thanks for coming on today. We really enjoyed having all of you, and we hope you show up next time.
Sir Duke again, and like we're gonna post all of the songs individually, so if you really want to listen to it, which I recommend, it's a great arrangement. It'll be up. We're gonna put it up. Hopefully next time we do something like this, the guys will be with me. That'll be fun. We get to see all of our faces up close. And we're also maybe getting new recording equipment, so things will improve, I swear. I think that that's all I wanted to say to you. Bye!